Morning. Today is Tuesday, October 29th, 2019, and you're watching the Daily Mix TV. Hi, my name is Sean Patrick Hillman. Is Walgreens helping us to slim down? Well, apparently Walgreens and Jenny Craig are teaming up to bring customers access to health and weight loss management services. They're opening about 100 Jenny Craig at Walgreens locations nationwide starting in January. Those locations are going to offer Jenny Craig's programs like the one-on-one consultations, a customized menu plan, and meal delivery. The locations will open in 20 states to start, and that's going to be markets like Dallas, Houston, Philadelphia, and Phoenix. Both companies said that they would start to explore other possible in-store and digital initiatives once the locations are open. This announcement comes as part of Walgreens' efforts to position itself as a neighborhood health destination. So here's what's going on with Walgreens. A year and a half ago, they did a national planogram reset, unifying under one plan. What a planogram is essentially your floor plan for your shelves, your displays, where brands go, what time of week or month are they featured in an end cap, that kind of thing. Here's the challenge with that, because they did it to save on cost and to unify the country in one simple plan. Well, here's the problem with that. As a retailer, part of your job is to cater to the local audience. Dwayne Reed is part of Walgreens. So when they did this reset, essentially they eliminated a lot of SKUs, stock keeping units, products, from the shelves that New Yorkers would purchase. So let me give you a great example. Location right downstairs in my building in New York City, they eliminated a lot of products that I use. So I now go to CVS three blocks away. The reason why they did this was pure cost cutting so that their volumes, in other words, how much product they're buying from specific vendors that appeal to a larger audience, those volume costs go down. So they're paying less per product and still charging the same amount of money. The challenge with that is you're losing customers. And there's a reason why Dwayne Reed is in the red. So Walgreens did this in order to save money as part of their plan. They're also looking at ways to customize programming from a health point of view. That's why they're doing things like this partnership with Jenny Craig. So neighborhood health destination efforts have included the expansion of their Find Care platform, as well as partnerships focused on diagnostic lab testing, primary care, urgent care, dental care, and optical offerings. And we've talked about this before, where they've laddered up with other companies to do these kinds of executions. From a business perspective, it's very smart. From a marketing perspective, the health destination thing is very smart. Unifying your planogram was not. So I'm hoping that this works out better for Walgreens than the last couple of announcements that they've had. Now, whenever you're co-oping with another company or brand, such as what Jenny Craig and Walgreens are doing, you need to make sure that your brand DNA and corporate culture align enough for this to make sense. In this case, it looks like they do. However, I would caution Jenny Craig in this deal, as Walgreens is having serious challenges in markets like New York with their Dwayne Reed brand. Always do your homework before partnering up with another company. Fried chicken lovers have a new way to enjoy the crispy food, minus the frying themselves part. To help curb that fried chicken craving, Tyson is launching its air fried chicken line, which comes in three varieties: breast strips, breast fillets, and chicken nuggets. Now, made with a simple amount of seasonings, the product also features golden breading and all white meat chicken that does not contain antibiotics, according to the company's press release. So, very smart move for Tyson. They were under fire a couple of years ago for the amount of oil they were using in their product. It sounds like they've woken up and they really understand what's going on. This is a good pivot for them and a good variant in their offering, an additional stock keeping unit in the cold chest. So hopefully this works out well for Tyson. Now, speaking of fried chicken, and who knew more than the Colonel himself, Kentucky Fried Chicken is getting into the Pez candy business just in time for Halloween. Remember when KFC released that fried chicken candle amongst a slew of other off-the-wall promos a few years ago? Well, this time I think they may have gone a little too far. The fried chicken fast food chain announced a few days ago, through a partnership with Funko, the public can buy a limited edition Pop Pez Colonel Sanders candy dispenser, complete with the Colonel's white beard and hair and signature eyeglasses. Funko collectibles have gained a lot of notoriety for their cartoonish renderings of some of pop culture's most notorious figures, and Lord knows Colonel Sanders is certainly one of them. The limited edition Colonel Sanders Pop Pez dispenser goes for about $5.99 on Amazon and at select retailers from Barnes & Noble to Pez.com. There are very limited quantities available for sale. Look, whenever KFC comes up with some announcement like this, you got to give it to Yum Brands. Very smart move. Gotta love it. Makes you smile and certainly pops into what's going on in pop culture. Macy's stores are upping their customization offerings in time for holiday shopping. The department store giant has launched several new in-store features, including a create your own jewelry program. Shoppers can work with a Macy's associate to choose gemstones, diamonds, metals, shapes, settings, and more via an in-store tablet. The options include engagement rings, wedding bands, necklaces, earrings, bracelets, and charms. Now, once the design is complete, the personalized piece will be delivered to the customer's home or local store in about 7 days. In addition, and I love this part, Macy's has launched a fragrance bar with interactive screens that activate when shoppers pick up a fragrance bottle, a scent stick, or by simply touching it. From there, customers can learn all about the fragrance, including the notes, the scent notes, information about the perfumer, and customer reviews. Each product has a QR code enabled for product purchase, allowing customers to scan and pay through Macy's mobile app, and they can do pickup in store. Now, on the furniture front, and this is very important, Macy's has rolled out its See Your Space IRL in real life. It's technology to about 140 of their doors nationwide. The technology allows shoppers to virtually see each piece in their home through the in-store VR experience with thousands of products to choose from. So, and that includes new additions like rugs, upholstery, and lighting. Now, essentially, you put on these glasses, if you've got an image of your home, you can actually put furniture and different, you know, accents into that room in real time and see it and then make the purchase. So starting in mid-November, the customize it feature will be available in a VR experience. Customers can choose from an assortment of different fabrics and colors to design a unique piece of furniture. They can also use their mobile device to visualize select furniture spaces or pieces, excuse me, in their space via augmented reality technology through Macy's app and make a purchase from their phone. So it's not just VR, it's also AR. You've got, you know, two plays going on at the same time. For Macy's, this is absolutely brilliant, especially with what's going on in department stores right now. I mean, and we've talked about this before, department store retail is having a serious challenge. And, you know, they keep calling it the Amazon effect, when in fact, it's just that retailers were so late to adopt the internet and to pivot their strategies to target a new generation. Because basically, they felt that they were the king of the hill and they owned the space. They didn't need to change. That is never true. Always be evolving. Always stay true to your brand DNA. But you do have to remember the customer is always right. It looks like Spotify has turned things around after all. The introduction of budget-friendly plans and a significant round of cost-cutting has helped return Spotify to a profit. The pioneering streaming site is halfway through transitioning from being just a music streamer to a media and cultural brand through podcasts, as well as some original content that they've been putting up. Now, in the third quarter, because remember, third quarter earnings were yesterday, they actually logged a $60 million operating profit, reaching 248 million monthly active users, including 113 million premium paying subscribers. That's very important because Pandora is down. There's a lot of challenges going on. Promotion and artist marketing has been slashed as the company attempts to get musicians to invest in, quote, sponsored recommendations. So, smart move for Spotify. I'm glad that they finally returned to profitability. it'll be interesting to see what their next move is. My name is Sean Patrick Hillman. I'm the editor-in-chief of The Daily Mix TV. If you guys have any story ideas, please email thedailymixtv@gmail.com. We'll see you guys tomorrow on Hump Day.